Hey everyone, this is the third episode of Wrapping Up Our History. I'm Frank, I'm studying at the University of Wollongong. And for one of my subjects, we had to pick a media niche and conduct an ethnographic study. So that's what I'm doing. My topic is hip-hop as a social commentary for Indigenous Australians. And each episode, I'll be taking a look at a few different songs, giving them a bit of a review and a discussion, hopefully to entice you to check the music out for yourself. So this week, we're doing it a bit different. We're going to look at three artists, including Briggs, Nookie, and Kobe D.
It was all fun and game until these drugs came. Popping pills and drinking liquor till the sun came. Ain't nobody there to tell us from a man's view. I was snorting coke and selling drugs like a man do. At least that's what I thought. I know that's not the way I was taught.
So to kick it off with Briggs, he's been around for a minute. He signed to Golden Era Records and started his own label, Bad Apples, in 2015. He didn't really come up on my radar until about 2016 when he released Reclaim Australia with Charles. I feel like this album was a big moment for our scene, especially within the context of what we're talking about. Briggs really brought more mainstream coverage of hip-hop as a social commentary in Australia, and I think one track that it can largely be attributed to is January 26th.
I said, hey Briggs, pick a date.
Okay.
You know what, we can celebrate.
For sure.
But we can come together, yeah. Talk about the weather, call that Australia Day. I said, how about March 8th?
That's a good one.
And we can do it on your nan's grave.
Oh, that bitch.
We can piss up, piss on the face, get lit up and burn out like Mark Skates. The screaming love will leave it, I got more reason.
Priding themselves on their jazzy and, excuse the irony, but golden era hip-hop style, AB Original addresses the controversy of the Australia Day date. January 26 marks the anniversary of the arrival of the First Fleet in 1788, but for many, and in particular the Indigenous Australian community, January 26 represents the tragedy their people faced from colonisation. This was a song that personally changed my own thinking of the day back in 2016, and really made me reflect a lot more on how these dates that are instilled in Australian culture are still extremely damaging. Briggs and Charles are witty as always, and while it's not as confrontational as some of the other work we've analysed, like Ziggy, I still think it's got its own sort of hostility that they create through, almost through like humour. It's a different approach, and as a listener, I wouldn't usually go out of my way to listen to them, but I really enjoyed this song and I have a lot of respect for the impact that it has today. So the next song that I want to check out is by someone from Briggs' Bad Apple label, Nara's very own, Nookie.
Blood on their hands, but no hands in the cuffs. 400 names, we're crying to say one.
Just say one.
Just say one.
Just say one.
Fuck it. Fuck it. Let's go an eye for an eye to the whole world blind. Maybe then they won't see color. Fuck it. Let's go an eye for an eye to the whole.
So this song was also produced by Charles and was released earlier this year. This one feels less like a song, but instead it's just a clear statement. It wasn't released on Spotify or anything like that. It was just a YouTube clip. And it addresses the over 400 lives that have been lost in police custody. And this is something that we talked about in episode one with JK. And this is one of the more raw performances that we've looked at. It tackles one side of this issue that has really come into light this year. And not a direct quote, but the lyrics are something along the lines of, every few years it pops up on the news, then you do a few posts, get some clicks, get some views, what it really do. I think lyrics like that, it's something that white Australians like myself really need to consider. It's all good and well to support these movements at their peak and when everyone's talking about it and sharing things about it, but we really need to support them until they're solved, and we need to support them correctly. The production on this one is great too. It's just some loud drums and this almost sort of like siren-like flute that plays throughout. Nookie's lyrics and energy completely dominate the track though, and I think that's what helps me get this message across the best. As for the next song we're checking out, an artist I found late last year with the release of Jody, he's a strong storyteller and an exciting lyricist, is Kobe D.
Makes me sick. January 26th is the day you have your barbies and you won't get pissed, but let me tell you how it is for my people. It's the day that we survived all evil and still standing strong.
Stand up.
I said we still stand strong.
We still stand strong. We still stand.
And we still stand strong.
In terms of social conscious rap in Australia, Kobe D is one of the coldest without a doubt. The sample of the vocals and this bluesy piano is such easy listening, and Kobe's entire verse is incredible. Leah Knight delivers such a simple chorus, but after the amount of storytelling that Kobe gives, it's exactly what I'm after. The thing I like most about Kobe is that his songs and storytelling give so much more of a personal look. For me, that's what hit home the most when I hear lyrics about personal stories and the micro look at growing up as an Indigenous Australian. Still Standing is a track where he probably does it the least, but songs like Jodie is where he does it the best, if you wanted to check that one out. But even on this one, lyrics like, "My cousin copped 10 years while yours graduated school." You know, I can't really describe what it is about it, but as a listener, I'm most engaged by this type of stuff. I think that's what hip-hop is all about. It's about that personal storytelling. And to tap into that while still sending such a strong message is really powerful for me as a listener. I see Kobe D having a really big next couple of years, so keep an eye on him for sure. I know this episode has been a short one. I'm wrapping up this assignment and this semester, so thank you for listening. This concludes the last episode of Wrapping Up Our History. Again, thank you if you've listened to all three episodes. And as always, the blog and all the links for the tracks will be linked below. And if you have been keeping up with the blog, I should have a big summary of the entire process, and the entire assignment should come out in the next couple of weeks. But yeah, this has been Wrapping Up Our History, episode 3. Thanks for listening.